Hi and hello guys. Previously I had posted a video on how you can dual boot Android TV version 10 alongside the Raspberry Pi OS on a Pi 4 board. So in this video, I will show you as to how you can dual boot or perhaps multi-boot multiple operating systems on a Pi board. So without any delay, let us get started. So the heart of the dual booting and the multi-booting procedure is this PIN application or software. This is in fact a fork or a modification or say betterment of the Noobs project, which you all must be probably aware of by now. To get started with, first head over to the PIN's homepage and then click on the Files tab. Now you will see a green color button that says download latest version pinlight.zip. Click on that and then download the pinlight zip file. You can in fact unzip the contents of the zip file onto an SD card and then boot your Pi using that card. And once you connect to the internet, you will get a list of different operating system options which you can choose and then download onto the Pi and then install it directly without performing any manual downloads over here. So, but there is a small hitch to that. If you just scroll your mouse over this button, it will give you the release date of the zip file or the application. It says that this was released on the 16th of February 2021. So the hitch is that the server doesn't list the operating systems that were uploaded post the release of the zip file. Say, as in if you take a look over here, you have a couple of operating systems that were uploaded post the release of the zip file. So in that online list, you won't get these operating systems. As a result, you need to manually download them and then use that for dual booting or multi-booting. Okay, I hope you got this. Say, in this video for demonstrating the multi-boot procedure, I'll be using the Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit version, the Retro Pi 4 version, and then the Lineage OS 18 Android TV build. All these work with Pi 4. Say, if you are using Pi 3, probably you can use the Pi 3 Android builds. And then the Raspberry Pi OS 32-bit versions that you can download from the downloads page of the raspberrypi.org website. Just a thing that I would like to point out at this moment is the files that have been provided for the Lineage OS 18 builds are broken, at least as of today. See, as you can see over here, these files system.tar.exe and then the other file, where is it? The vendor.tar.exe are broken. They in fact should be vendor.img.exe and system.img.exe. Okay, so these files are broken. I have already notified the developer. I have attached the mega link which has got the fixed list of files. Okay, so for see, if you want to run the Android TV 18.1 on your Raspberry Pi 4 board, then you can use these files instead of the files hosted in the PIN's official page. That is until these files get fixed. So to download the files, you need to download all these files one by one. Yep. Okay. The same goes for the Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit version as well. So if you feel that this process is cumbersome, alternately you can use JDownloader and then download all these files in one shot. Just copy the address of the list of the files from the address bar over here. Immediately the JDownloader should parse the files from this page. See, if it does not do this procedure automatically, just click on this plus add new links and then paste the link over here. Select your address over here. Make sure to uncheck the auto extract option and then just give continue. Okay, so now the files have been passed and you need to assign the directory or folder where you want the files to be downloaded. Okay, so the first set has got all the necessary files, and then in the second package you have a couple of images that is used by the PIN while the installation is being performed. Okay, all these images go under the slides underscore VGA folder. So I have assigned the path as Lineage 18 RPi ATV, and for this will be lineage 18 rpy atv / slides underscore vga. That is a subfolder within the lineage os folder. And before you start downloading, just make sure that you have got the auto extract disabled. Give Ctrl A or press Ctrl A, right click and choose start all downloads. See, if you want to use the 32-bit version of the Raspberry Pi OS, head over to the downloads.raspberrypi.org page, and then you can choose either the full version of the Raspberry Pi OS 32-bit that comes with all the pre-installed applications. There is another desktop version which comes with limited applications pre-installed, and then you have the server or the light version without any desktop environment. It's absolutely your choice. Download the operating system as per your convenience. Just like the pin files, you can download all these files also using the JDownloader. Just copy the address. Click on the image tab over here, not on the checkbox, just on this row over here. This will list out all the images that have been passed. You don't need these GIF files. Just delete those packages alone. You don't need them. And just a word of caution over here. I don't know, for some weird reason, the JDownloader doesn't parse the JSON files. So you need to manually download the two JSON files over here, the os.json and the partitions.json. Okay, so that is the small hiccup with respect to downloading the Raspberry Pi OS files using JDownloader. Okay, you can merge all these files into one package. Select all the Raspberry Pi OS files, that is the 32-bit files, right click and choose other, and then move into new package. Choose OK. And for this again, assign the desired path where you need to download all these files. Okay. So I have already downloaded these files, so I'm not downloading them right now. So follow a similar procedure for the RetroPie as well. Copy the path. Immediately the file should be passed over here. Okay, so the slides underscore VGA will automatically be picked up, and then the separate fold, the files under the separate folder called DSI, will also be picked up. Just make sure to have these files under dedicated subfolders within the parent folder called RetroPie 4. Okay, again, it's RetroPie. This will be RetroPie for / DSI, and this will be RetroPie DSI. Okay. So once that is done, you can give Ctrl A, right click and choose start all downloads. See, if you are planning to use the Android TV build, I would suggest you to download the gaps from the Open Gaps page. I will leave the link for this gaps file in the description of this video. Just in case, I will mirror this gaps file in my Mega account as well. Just to make sure that you have access to the gaps file, even if Open Gaps chooses to delete this from over here. Okay, so that's pretty all done now. So moving on, now you need to prepare your SD card to house the pin application. Okay, so first I would suggest you to erase your SD card using the SD formatter application. This SD formatter is the go-to application for erasing any SD cards or pen drives or thumb drives or memory devices. Okay, so this application is available for both Windows and Mac users. I will leave the link for this application in the description of this video. So select your SD card and have the formatting option set to quick format, and then choose format. Then choose yes. Okay, and now you should get a prompt that the formatting is complete. Give OK and then close. Now head over to the location where you have all the files downloaded. Right click on the pinlight zip file, choose extract files, and then select the SD card which you just formatted, and then choose OK. So once that is done, you need to copy all the operating system files that you just downloaded onto a thumb drive. So you cannot just like that copy all the operating system files onto the thumb drive or pen drive and then try to use them for installation processes. You cannot do that. There's a small catch over here. Say if your thumb drive is lesser than 4 gigabytes, it needs to be formatted to FAT32 format. Okay. Say if you are using a thumb drive larger than 4 gigabytes, then it should be formatted to EXT4 format. Okay. So EXT4 is a Linux partition format. So EXT4 is a Linux partition. So you probably may have to use your Raspberry Pi to format the thumb drive and then copy the files onto it. Okay. So from my observation, having gone through all these processes for quite some time, a 4GB thumb drive is more than sufficient for, say, almost 3 operating system installations. It can easily take in 3 copies of 3 operating systems. So 4GB thumb drive is more than sufficient. See, if you plan to use more than that, just make sure to have your thumb drive formatted to EXT4 format and then copy the files onto that. Okay. So open the thumb drive that you plan to use for the installation. Create a new directory within the thumb drive and call it as OS. So the OS directory is a must. Without this, your operating system files will not get detected by PIN. Okay. So do not skip this process. Now head back to the location where you have all the operating systems downloaded. Say if you are using the Android TV build, download the RAR file, right click and then choose extract here. So this will create a new folder that says Lineage 18 RPi ATV, okay, RPi 4 ATV. So copy the operating systems that you would like to use. So I'm using the 64-bit version of the Raspberry Pi OS, RetroPie 4 and then the Android TV build, okay. Copy these files and then place them inside the OS directory of your thumb drive. While that is happening, you can probably copy the gaps as well. So there is no hard and fast rule as to where you need to have the gaps. You can have the gaps outside the OS folder. It's absolutely fine. It is just that the operating system files need to be within the OS folder. Okay, so now all the files have been copied onto the thumb drive. Okay, so those are all the preliminary steps that you need to do. We'll now proceed with the actual installation process. Unplug the SD card and the thumb drive from your computer, insert it onto the Pi and then now boot your Pi. Okay, so now the Pi is booting up and you should see the PIN interface or the PIN menu in a short time. Okay, so now we have the PIN menu. In these tabs, you can actually see the operating systems that you have copied onto the thumb drive. See, if you connect to the Wi-Fi now, you will get access to the several other operating systems that have been uploaded to the PIN server. As you can see over here, you don't have the RetroPie 3 version that was added to the list post the release of the PIN application in February. Okay. So that is the small hitch over here and that is why I asked you to manually download the files. Other than the operating systems that you downloaded, if you wish to add more operating systems, you can select the operating systems from here. Okay. To select the operating systems, click on the box next to it. You will have a cross against it. So I have got the Lineage OS 18 ATV build selected. I have got the RetroPie selected. And then let me now select the Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit version. See, if you look at the images on the right side, you will find that there are two distinct symbols. One is the USB symbol and another one is the Ethernet port symbol. So the USB symbol denotes that the operating system copy has been obtained from the thumb drive that you have connected. And the Ethernet port symbol denotes that the operating system needs to be downloaded from the internet. Okay, so that's just a piece of information for you. Okay, so now that we have got the three operating systems selected, make a note of the space that these operating systems take up and the space that is available on your SD card. So there is some difference between the space needed and the available space. So you are good to go. Make sure to appropriately select the destination drive and now choose install. Choose yes. So this process will take quite some time. You can probably head out for a coffee or a beer and then come back to find the process finished. At the end of the installation process, you should get a pop-up that says that the operating systems or the OSs have been successfully installed. Click on OK. Now you can see the list of the operating systems that have been installed. Okay. So just you can scroll through the operating systems, select the operating system that you want and then boot into it. Right now, I'll show you as to how you can install GAPS on the Android TV build. Now the Lineage OS is loading and you can see the Lineage OS logo. Okay, so as it is, you won't find the Google applications of the softwares. You need to add the GAPS to the Android TV build. First step, head over to the settings, choose device preferences, and then choose about. Scroll down until you get to the option that says build. Keep pressing on the build button. Now the developer options have been enabled. Go back, click on the gear icon again, click on device preferences. Scroll down, head over to the developer options menu. Within here, select or enable the advanced reboot option. That is all that you need to do within the developer options menu. You can now head back again. In order to reboot to recovery, click on settings, device preferences, scroll down until you see an option that says reboot. Click on the reboot option and then select recovery. Unlike the normal Android TV build, which immediately reboots to the TWRP, in this case, this will again go through the PIN menu or the PIN application. Once again, when the PIN loads, you need to select the Lineage OS option to boot into TWRP. So now the TWRP is loading. Swipe to allow modifications. As a first step, click on the mount tab. Select all the partitions to mount. Now head back and then head over to the install option. As it is, you won't see the GAPS file that you just downloaded. You need to select the storage. Click on select storage option and select the USB that you have connected to the Pi. Choose OK. And now you should see the GAPS file. Click on the GAPS file. Make sure to leave these two unchecked. You don't need these two options. Now swipe to confirm flash. Okay, so now the GAPS have been successfully installed. Before you reboot, choose wipe Dalvik and now swipe to wipe. And now head back. Click on the reboot option and select system. So once again, the reboot will be channeled through the PIN application or software. Select the Lineage OS build to boot into the Android TV OS. Okay, at the start, you should see this remote logo. Press on the F2 key. Press on the F1 key. And now you will be taken to the welcome screen. Just follow the on-screen instructions to set up the Android TV build. So once you add your Google account, it will present you with the terms of service. Just follow the on-screen instructions once again. Okay, so now we can see the YouTube and Google Play movies and TV app installed on your Raspberry Pi. So you have the Google Play services installed as well. So I'm not going to go through the testing of this build. So let me quickly shut down this build and try booting into the other operating systems that we just installed. So now we are back into the pin menu. So let's this time try booting RetroPie. Okay, so the RetroPie is now booted up and running, I would say. Okay, so the RetroPie has booted. Okay, so now let's quickly shut down the RetroPie and then head back and test the 64-bit version of the Raspberry Pi OS. So now let's boot into the 64-bit version of the Raspberry Pi OS. Okay, so the Raspberry Pi is booted. So now we have the 64-bit operating system up and running. So let's quickly check the kernel version. So this is currently running the 5.4.51 version of the kernel. And as you can see over here, it says ARCH64. That is the 64-bit version of the operating system. Okay, so the 64-bit version builds from the pin repository dates back to almost last year, the 20th of August 2020. You can probably upgrade the distro right here from the terminal, okay? So that's easy to do. And you'll have the updated version of the Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit version. So that is pretty much it, guys. So that is how you can dual boot or say multi boot multiple operating systems on your Pi. A lot of effort has gone into making this video. So I really hope that you find this video useful and informative. Thanks for watching. Take care. Stay safe. See you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.